Yeah. quest, ball bag.
You knew this would.
Do me a favor, brother. You see any more of these ghostly berserker tossers, give them the same. You'll be doing the Nine Realms a favor.
Did these warriors wrong you at some point, Mimir? You're quite agitated, even for you.
No need to rehash ancient history if it's all the same to you.
Very well.
Where is Sigrun now?
Impossible to say. She's on a mission spanning the realms in search of our lost sisters. Our hope is if she can bring their incorporeal spirits to Vanaheim, we can find a way to restore them to uncorrupted forms.
Shame about Tyr's vault. I'll take whatever you manage to salvage from it, though.
When you want to find the Nords, we'll return to the spell. Alfheim, what's there?
We still have unfinished business there. There's still that secret elven library in Alfheim.
Lead the way. Do you regret it, Mimir?
Most likely. Dad, what are we talking about in particular?
Giving up your body?
Do I regret exchanging my life for my freedom? That's a question I ask myself every day, my lady.
What about today?
Today? Glad to be out in the world. How else could I spend such quality time with you?
Okay. Much of the sand has been cleared away, but another storm rages beyond that pass, which must mean...
Another Hafgufa!
Odd. It looks as though the Light Elves sealed off this section of the Barrens. Why?
Luckily for us, a very considerate goddess has enhanced our magic chisel, and we can unseal it.
My. That is lucky.
The Forbidden Sands lay beyond.
Contested territory, according to Bela. And another storm to endure.
I remember when Freyr and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing Hafgufa. But I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim. Well, best we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave!
On one of my horns. Let's see if I can pull it off.
No.
Archive of knowledge.
No sign of the Light Elves.
For now.
Maybe they've left for the day, and we can browse at our leisure. So, these are the Valine schematics, eh? Aye, one of the most gifted dwarven smiths around. Until he developed a conscience, anyhow.
These texts alone are not enough to end the Elven War. But restricting their access only serves those who wish to prolong it.
Taking a page out of Odin's book.
Aye. Quite the advantage for the Light Elves. Bigvir spoke of an exile of the same name. Odds are he'd like a gander at that particular text.
All this knowledge of their ancestors, their shared history, poetry. Just sitting here, forgotten. What a waste.
Swapper. Ah, it appears the librarian would like a word.
Lata Framborg.
Sounds like she wants that journal back.
No.
Shield strike!
Oh!
feet. How Gabriel did not.
She thinks she's protecting them by hiding all this knowledge away.
Our ally wishes to read this journal. We are taking the book.
I'm impressed. Thought you were going to end her.
When last we traveled here, after Faye passed, I killed an elf of great importance. The ramifications were dire for his people. I do not wish to make the same mistake twice.
I see an entrance!
I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet. Once this Hofgoofer is free. This architecture, it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive matter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track, then.
What kind of hive material is sensitive to sound? How odd. When I last came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was covered by hive matter.
Aye. And as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even that Hathgifer for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
Hive, but denser.
Wretch on the left!
Thank you.
Changes hands often in Alfheim, or so it appears.
Bigthyr did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corpse below would disagree. Let's continue, shall we?
Changing arrows!
It's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate. I wonder if these two comprehend the choice they face once free.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hakufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
And without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for in the end. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Given another chance.
gone!
Good. Almost there.
Run!
To the surface, then.
Changing arrows!
You're on fire, Sneakon. They will fire.
Alka!
Behind you! Incoming!
Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
Yeah.
these creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such power. So the blacksmith used the flame of...
Kratos, is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but... Well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now, don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
Well, at least it's a relatable story.
Years we've overstayed our welcome in our time.
those two keys.
What are they keeping back there?
That's the beauty of a locked door. It could be anything. Monsters, treasure. Knowing our luck, it'll be a bit of both.
Yeah! coming!
Yeah!